Welcome to the first teaching unit in the chapter Solar Inverters with the title MPP-Tracking. Over the last weeks, you have now learned a lot about how solar cells work, how they are manufactured, and most recently about PV modules. In this and the following chapter, we will turn to PV systems. We will first look at a very simple PV system. We connect a solar module with a very simple load, an ohmic resistor, for example, a light bulb. To understand what is happening next, let's briefly recall. Here you can see the familiar IV curve of a PV module. The power is the product of current and voltage. The PV characteristic therefore results directly from the IV characteristic. It is easy to see that there is a point of maximum power. We recall the associated voltage, VMPP, and the associated current in the VI curve, IMPP. The MPP is usually located at the knee of the IV curve. In order to get the maximum power out of the module, we have to run it right at this point. But what does the operation point of the module actually depend on? According to the Ohm's law, the current through the resistor corresponds to the quotient of the applied voltage and the resistance. This is therefore a linear relationship between current and voltage. For the IV curve of the resistor, this linear relationship means that it is a straight line. We see that the IV curve of the resistor intersects the curve of the module at a certain voltage. It is this intersection that marks the operating point of the PV module. Ideally, this operating point would correspond exactly to the MPP of the module, or would be close to it, like in the case shown here. The module would then deliver the maximum possible power to the resistor. If, however, the irradiance on the module changes, the current of the module IV curve drops. This results in a new intersection, which in the case shown here is far away from the MPP. In practice, the voltage at which the module is operated is therefore decoupled from the voltage of the consumer. This way, the module can be operated at the point of maximum power regardless of the irradiance. For decoupling, the voltages of the load and the PV module, usually a DC-DC converter is used. This DC-DC converter transforms the input voltage of the PV module into the desired output voltage. So, we now have the option of setting the voltage on the module independently of the load. Now we only have to find out the MPP voltage of the module and can then operate the module in the MPP. This process, that is to say the finding of the MPP, is called maximum power point tracking, or MPPT. An MPP tracker observes the IV curve of a module or an array of several modules and searches for the MPP. As a rule, current and voltage are measured for this purpose. The DC-DC converter then operates the module at the voltage determined by the MPP tracker. But how exactly does such an MPP tracker find the MPP voltage? Of course, if we look at the curve, it is easy to find this point. But how does it work in the field? There are many different approaches. One that is often used is the so-called perturb and observe method. First, the power is determined at some point on the IV curve. Then the resistance on the solar module is changed in small steps and the new module power is determined. If the power is higher than before, then the search direction is correct and the resistance is changed further in this direction. If the power drops, the search direction is changed in the opposite direction. With this method, the operating point always oscillates around the actual MPP. The size of the jumps is therefore optimized in such a way that the resulting losses are as low as possible. The accuracy of the MPP tracker can be measured using the static efficiency. Static here means that the ambient conditions do not change. This efficiency is defined as the ratio of the energy at the actual operating point to the energy at the operating point with maximum power. Good MPP trackers achieve a static efficiency of over 99%. Very good controllers even reach 99.8%. If the ambient conditions remain the same, the losses caused by the MPP tracker are therefore less than 1%. But what happens if the irradiation or the temperature change? As a result, the characteristic of our module also changes. With the old MPP voltage, the module no longer delivers the maximum power under the new conditions. In this case, the MPP tracker needs a short time to find the new MPP. Changing environmental conditions therefore lead to additional losses. There are various algorithms that manufacturers of MPP controllers use to counter this problem. This is where the wheat is separated from the chaff. The more sophisticated the algorithm of the MPP tracker, the faster it will find the MPP even under changing conditions. Let's take a closer look at the environmental conditions that influence the MPP voltage. You already know that the voltage of a solar module depends mainly on the module temperature, while the irradiation has a rather small, namely logarithmic, influence. For MPP tracking, the irradiation is nevertheless of greater importance, as it can change significantly faster than the module temperature. This is mainly due to the thermal mass of the PV modules, which gives the module temperature a certain inertia. The module temperature changes only slowly, and there are no sudden jumps in the characteristic curve. However, with rapidly changing cloud cover, there are sudden jumps in the irradiation. It is precisely these sudden and rapid changes in the characteristic curves that are problematic for the MPP controller. Let's look at the dependence of the MPP voltage on the irradiation. The MPP voltage remains almost constant above 300 watt per square meter. If the irradiation changes in this area, this does not lead to any major changes in the MPP voltage. The situation changes if we look at the range below 300 watt per square meter. If the irradiation suddenly jumps from 200 to 1000 watts per square meter, the MPP voltage changes significantly. This would be the case, for example, in a sunny day with passing clouds. But also in the morning and evening hours, the irradiation changes in a low radiation range. To describe the behavior of an MPP tracker under changing irradiation, the dynamic efficiency is used. Just like the static efficiency, dynamic efficiency describes the ratio of the energy actually provided by the PV generator to the theoretical possible energy in the MPP. However, the dynamic efficiency is determined under rapidly changing irradiation, while with the static efficiency, irradiation is kept constant. With a very good MPP controller, the dynamic efficiency is only slightly lower than the static one and is still over 99.5%. In the previous considerations, we have made an important assumption. We have assumed that the IV curve of the module corresponds to that of an individual solar cell. But in practice, this is not always the case. Just remember the IV curve of a module that is partially shaded. In this case, there are several local maxima in the power curve. If there is shading on the PV module, then the MPP tracker levels itself at a lower local maximum using the method just described, and to a certain extent sticks to it. The actual maximum power point, the global maximum, is not found in this case. MPP trackers, which can also be used for shaded PV systems, therefore scan the entire IV curve at regular intervals in order to search for a global MPP. While the IV curve is being fully scanned, the PV module is only operated for a short moment in the MPP, which inevitably leads to losses. Therefore, the frequency of these large scan loops is chosen to be as low as possible. If shading is unavoidable when planning a PV system, it is essential to ensure that the inverter is suitable for shading. So that leaves us with one last question. Which device does take care of the MPP tracking? As you may have guessed, the function of the MPP controller is usually integrated in the inverter. In standalone systems that are not connected to the power grid, MPP tracking can also be integrated in the charge controller of a battery. Let me summarize the main points of this unit for you. The operating point and thus the voltage of a PV module is determined by the connected resistance. In order to always be able to operate a PV module close to its MPP, the voltage of the consumer and the PV module are decoupled. An MPP controller searches for the MPP using a sophisticated algorithm. Changes in irradiation and shading are particularly challenging. Thank you for your attention.